A few more artists gonna come up here and entertain y'all before we get out of here. So we got a kid coming up here, man. He's a veteran in the game. So I need y'all to show y'all love for none other than Julius Bogo. Show your love for Julius Bogo.
Appreciate that. What's going on, y'all? Happy Father's Day to all the fathers that's here. Yeah, give it up for the fathers. I'm going to go get right into my set. I went to go get my car detailed the other day, and I had couldn't find some weed I had lost in the car. Yeah, so, you know, when I leave the car wash, I'm like, damn. Who got my weed and shit? So I wasn't gonna go back to the damn car wash. Hey, look, man, one of y'all stole my weed and shit. So about a week later, I found the weed. It was in the console and shit, you know, hidden and shit. And I was like, look at God. Won't he do it for you? And I know sometimes certain things you used to do, you can't do no more. For example, I can't smoke Reggie no more. I get bad. I have terrible dreams and nightmares and shit. I had the most craziest dream in the world not too long ago. I smoked some Reggie. I messed around and had a dream that I was doing a comedy show at a Ku Klux Klan gathering. Yeah. The motherfucker, the host didn't even want to bring me up. I'm in the green room and shit. He's like, hey man, you gotta go out there, you gotta introduce yourself. I said, God damn, what the fuck going on here? So I introduced myself. I came out, I said, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for no other than Julius Bogo. And I came out. I said, how y'all motherfuckers doing? All y'all got on these white bed sheets and shit. I see y'all as uniformity up in this motherfucker. And why is your shit yellow? That's just nasty now. That's just nasty. Soap and Tide and goddamn Peach will take care of that. Then somebody said, get that nigga. I said, that's my time. Gotta go. How many of y'all have taken that COVID shot? The vaccination? Okay, look here. Give it up for this brother right here. All right. I have no problem if you decide to get the shot or if you don't get the shot. My problem is when people come at you like you stupid because you choose not to get the shot. And see, somebody came to me the other day and I had to put their ass in check. No. Yeah. Oh yeah, they're gonna talk about, oh, so you mean to tell me that you trust your weed man more than you trust the government? That's right. I said, you goddamn right I trust my weed man more than I trust the government. My weed man, for one, ain't never sold me no bullshit. He ain't never murdered nobody. He ain't never falsely accused anybody of having weapons of mass destruction and damn near started World War III. And he ain't never experimented on anybody in Tuskegee. Matter of fact, it was about 10 years ago, somebody was telling me it was going to be a day that was coming where it was a global, worldwide pandemic. Motherfuckers going to be losing their mind, stocking up on water, toilet tissue, gas, hand sanitizer, wearing masks every fucking where that they went. You wanna know who told me that shit? My weed man. I call that motherfucker Weed Stradamus, goddamn. He better than 1,000. How many of y'all remember the TV show Good Times? Make some noise. All right. That was a good TV show back then. Now, y'all know when Good Time came on the theme song, it actually is Good Times, but let's be real. The name of that TV show should be called The Struggle Is Real. Because I watched like a 3-hour marathon of Good Times, and I'm like, where in the hell were the Good Times at? What did I see in 3 hours? I saw Penny Mama burn her ass with an iron. I see JJ get shot by some nigga named Mad Dog. I saw James die on the job. And what was Florida talking about? Damn. Damn. I said, where the hell the goddamn Good Times at? Even when that shit comes on, don't it sound like an old Negro spiritual?
Yes, sir.
Be like, I'm looking around, there's some slaves in this motherfucker. Cool, is that you? And you really think about it, man. Good Times, I want y'all to help me out with this theme song, okay? You know, because no matter what they say in that theme song, they always say Good Times. Keeping your head above, making a wage when you can, temporary layoffs, Good Times, right? So when I hold the mic out, I want y'all to say Good Times, okay? This is going to be the 2021 version. So Good Times came on today. It will be talking about things that reflect on what's going on in today's world, right? Okay, here we go. Keeping your head above water, making a way when you can, baby mama drama.
Good time.
Donald Trump is tripping.
Good time.
Positive COVID test.
Good time.
Hurricane Harvey.
Good time.
We'll be lucky we got them. Doom, do, 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 do.
Good time.
You know that picture, that portrait that's on at the internet? A lot of people say that's JJ. That's not no damn JJ. Now see, that's why I try to tell black people, don't be running your mouth not knowing what the hell you're talking about, telling people some shit. That painting is actually called The Sugar Shack. It's painted by Eddie Barnes. Eddie Barnes also happened to be, it's also the album cover of Marvin Gaye's album, I Want You. And it's also, Eddie Barnes is also a football player. He got drafted by the Baltimore Colts, and because of this, the day before social media and all the video footage, he was picked in the eighth round by the Baltimore Colts, but the pick got rescinded because they found out he was black. So he got put back in the draft, and he got picked up in the 10th round by the Washington Redskins. And this concludes the black history portion of my comedy set. Maybe y'all learned something, I don't know. I got this, I'm trying not to use the N-word. Yeah, it's hard. It's hard sometimes not to use that N-word. Matter of fact, I got a bigger problem. I'm trying not to use three N-words. And I use them all together. Three N-words. Let me give you an example. I'm going to give you two examples of what I'm talking about. I was in Walmart the other day. I mean, they had a wrong time of the day, wrong day. All the lines are long as a motherfucker, right? So I just went in there for a few items. So I'm waiting. Take up steps forward. Waiting, take up steps forward. Now it's my turn. The brother behind the cash register is going to tell me I got to go get back in one of these lines, and he cuts the light on talking about he's about to get off work now. That's when I pulled them three N-words. I said, not now, nigga. You got one more goddamn customer. Cut that goddamn light back on. I said, you can either check me out, I'll check myself out, or you can go get somebody. Not now, nigga. Now, you don't always have to use not now, nigga, to somebody else. You can use it to yourself. Like, example. Say, fellas, you've been with a woman, you got with a woman for the first time, y'all about to do y'all thing and shit. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, you about to get that first stroke there, and then, you know, sometimes you got that woo-woo. You know, you get it like, woo-woo. And you find out on that first stroke that you got 10 consecutive strokes before you about to bust that nut, right? So you got to be smart about this shit. You know, you hit that motherfucker 6, 7, 8, 9, nigga. Back out. Eat a little pussy, do something, goddamn it. Hell, 9, nigga. You got to preserve yourself, goddamn it. Shut up. I can be a veteran, 20 years, U.S. Army. Thank you. Appreciate that. And one of the best days to a veteran is Veterans Day. Why? Because we get the motherfucking hookup. A lot of the food establishments, they honor us by giving us free meals all damn day. So this, and many times veterans are very proud men and women that do not want to appear as if they're taking advantage of the military benefits and entitlements. Well, not me. I gave Uncle Sam 20 years of my life. I'm going to get every motherfucking thing that I can. So this past Veterans Day, I went to Applebee's, Boston Market, Buffalo Wild Wings, Chipotle, Chili's, Denny's, Golden Corral, Hooters, IHOP, Krispy Kreme, Little Caesars, Longhorn Steakhouse, Outback Steakhouse, Ponderosa Steakhouse, Ruby Tuesday, Red Robin, Red Lobster, Starbucks, Taco Cabana, Winnie's, and Zaxby's. Just to name a few of them.
Okay.
Now, that's why I remember all the restaurants like that. You'll give me entirely too much credit. I just went in alphabetical order. And if there's anybody that should be surprised I remember them, it should be myself. I said, I smoked some weed about 30 minutes ago. And the moral of that story is, there is none. I was just telling y'all what the fuck I did this past Veterans Day. Now, y'all probably noticed I was dancing in here and naming all those restaurants off. You know, I did that because I'm tired of seeing black people when they're in food commercials, establishments, they're always singing and dancing. You ever notice that shit? And this is pop, this is a commercial I can't stand right now. That's a Popeyes commercial. Y'all don't see this Popeyes commercial, right? It's a brother with a pair of glasses standing up with a bag of chicken in his hands. He's talking about, ooh, baby, I got Popeyes. I said, oh my God, this nigga done set black people back about 25 years with this bullshit. I'm gonna leave one more joke with y'all. I'll be 50 years old this year. It's gonna be funny right here. and I got concerns, real concerns, because right now everything is good. Everything worked good, knock on wood. But I got concerns because I be hearing people talking and shit. Now, my main concern is, what do you do when the pickle don't do what you want it to when you need it to? What do? You know, and of course the obvious is what? Viagra, Sea Islands, whatever, you know. But what do you do when that don't work? I got to thinking about this shit. I said, damn, that's a good question, you know?
Yeah.
So I got to thinking about this shit. I came up with an answer. I said, you know what? You go to the store and you buy yourself a strap-on. Yeah, you got to be creative. Bring that shit to your bed, put you in shit just in case you got, you know, you got a problem, you got a flat tire. Bring it to bed, put it on your waist, put it to the side. You know, when you get ready to get busy, you got that flat tire and shit. That's when you gotta be like MacGyver. You gotta be like Inspector Gadget. You be like, go get your strap on and wear that motherfucker out. You see what I'm saying? And who knows? Who knows? Maybe the stroking and her moaning, you know, it might start waking that pickle up. You know, you be like, wait a minute. Wait a goddamn minute. I'm back. I'm back. Go get your Brio dicks. Bring that motherfucker around and beat that motherfucker. Now see, some of y'all talking about y'all wouldn't do that shit, but I'm just saying, look here, if your woman tells you that she wants some dick in her pussy, you better put some dick in her pussy. It needs to be coming from you. And I'm